Philippine Senator Francis Tolentino stepping down as chair of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee in January. Tolentino says he wishes to honor an agreement with the Senate leadership that he would only head the Blue Ribbon Committee for a year and a half. The senator also admits his re-election plans for 2025 are also part of the reason for this move.
It is my intention to honor an agreement in fulfillment of a sacred commitment to serve as Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman and member of the Commission on Appointments for a concise term of 1.5 years, I find it both a duty and an honor to uphold the essence of a prior agreement. This decision is rooted in a deep-seated belief that public office demands fidelity to pledges made.
A groundbreaking security pact. That's what a security analyst calls a planned military pact between the Philippines and Japan. Dr. Chester Cabalsa says this is the first time Japan is elevating its commitment to sharing its defense expertise with the Philippines. Cabalsa notes Japan has significant experience in warfare as well as modern technology.
It means a lot for the Philippines because all of a sudden we are becoming attractive to the region, but there are, of course, repercussions to this. Mm-hmm. One of which is, of course, China will feel more insecure because of this attractiveness that Manila is gaining so far. Secondly, China will be asking what would be the interest of our partners and allies in the region because they felt that this is a contagion on their part. And thirdly, I think we will see more miscommunications because of the unilateral aggression of China in the South China Sea.
The Philippine president calling for a paradigm shift in Manila's approach in its maritime row with China. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. spoke to reporters in Tokyo over the weekend. He says a new approach to the dispute is needed as Philippine diplomatic efforts with Beijing are heading in a poor direction. Marcos had told the gathering of ASEAN leaders in Japan a more aggressive China is posing a real challenge in the region. As for Beijing, it warns the Philippines relying on major powers for help in the dispute will only escalate tensions.
China has always been committed to maintaining peace and stability in the South China Sea through dialogue and consultations with ASEAN countries, including the Philippines. At the same time, China is resolute in its determination to safeguard its territorial sovereignty and maritime rights and interests. We hope the Philippines could realize that it is vain for it to pin the hope in tying itself up with certain major powers to corner China. Such attempts will ultimately harm its own interests and regional peace and stability.
The primary suspect in the disappearance of beauty queen Catherine Camilon was a no-show at the preliminary investigation into the case. Let's get more details now from Jeff Caparas. Jeff?
Yes, Ron. Rose Camilon personally appeared at the Batangas City Hall of Justice Tuesday for the preliminary investigation of cases of kidnapping and illegal detention filed against Police Major Alan De Castro, the primary suspect on the disappearance of her youngest daughter, Miss Grand Philippines 2023 candidate Catherine Camilon. It has been months, more than 2 months, Ron, since Catherine was seen by her relatives. Rose appealed to the police to help locate Catherine. Also present in the hearing are two witnesses, Catherine's sister, and the lawyer of the other accused, De Castro's driver, Jeffrey Magpantay. De Castro, you're right, Ron. De Castro is a no-show in the preliminary investigation. The complaint was received by his lawyer on his behalf. The lawyer said they only just received a subpoena and will study the complaint against his client. De Castro remained in restrictive custody at Camp Vicente Lim in Laguna. Camilon was last seen on October 12. In November, two witnesses appeared at CIDG Region 4A and said they saw three men carrying a bloodied woman to a red SUV from gray SUV of Camilon. The red SUV was recovered in an abandoned lot in Batangas, where authorities recovered hair strands and blood samples that later on matched the DNA of Catherine's family. Ron, the next preliminary investigation is set on January 9, 2024. Back to you, Ron.
Jeff Caparas with that report. Thanks, Jeff. The Environment Department urging the public to conserve water due to the effects of the El Nino phenomenon. We have more from Rafael Bosano.
It was just right before the pandemic when a water crisis amplified Metro Manila's growing demand for water. The Philippine Environment Department warns of possible major problems as El Nino stretches until mid-2024.
The pressure from this faucet is strong, but eateries like these opt to conserve water by using pails and buckets to wash their dishes. According to the MWSS, washing dishes under a continuously flowing faucet can consume up to 102 liters of water.
This is just one of the many little changes the public can do to cushion the impact of El Nino. 90% of Metro Manila's water requirement is sourced from Angat Dam. Latest data from the State Weather Bureau show that the water level in Angat is 213.24 meters, slightly above its 212-meter normal high water level. For now, the focus is on conserving water.
We're trying to preserve it that way so that once we enter 2024, it's at its maximum volume. However, you know, from our calculations, the amount of water that we have from Angat and from other sources will be good, no, for all our supply until around May or June of 2024. If the El Nino event, no, next year progresses.
The Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System says should Angat's water level dip by mid-2024, the El Nino would have already waned.
Base na din po dun sa El Nino ENSO alert, no, ng ating pag-asa ay ang sabi po niya ay magiging neutral na daw yung epekto ng El Nino sa atin by comes June or July. At ito naman po ay yung transition time at tumataas na rin yung percent probability na magkakaroon po tayo ng La Nina by June or July.
Water concessionaires Maynilad and Manila Water say a repeat of the 2019 water crisis is unlikely, but it doesn't mean it won't happen.
Sa ngayon, hindi pa namin, hindi natin nakikita na mangyayari ito dahil po sa magiging epekto nung ng El Nino for sa 2024. Marami na rin naman pong ginawa at ginagawa pa ang Maynilad bilang paghahanda po sa mga scenarios like this, ano? Katulad na nga po na paglalagay po ng mga bagong water treatment or water sources or yung mga water treatment facilities para po magkaroon po ng ano, augmentation dun sa supply natin mula sa Angat.
El Nino ka o walang El Nino, kahit na tag-ulan or tag-init, dapat we all practice responsible use of water and kung po pwede talaga na i-recycle ang water, especially dun sa mga households.
The DENR says 135 water projects that require private sector funding are in the works so that communities facing water scarcity may be given access to potable water. And while many consumers experience a steady supply of water, simple acts of repairing leaks and consciously turning off faucets when not in use can go a long way in conserving valuable water resources. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.